Trench is the deepest part of the ocean on our planet, which is why it is home to many strange and dangerous creatures, many of which you would never believe exist in this world. In today's video, we will cover 10 creatures from the Mariana Trench. You probably would be thankful that they are down deep there and don't come to the surface or land. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Number 10, Vampire Squid. If you think that vampires only exist in movies, you're mistaken. You know what? In Mariana Trench, there are also vampire squids. The vampire squid, aptly named for its propensity to feed on blood, is now restricted to depths of at least 600 to 900 meters, or 2,000 feet. Despite their name, squid actually use filaments on their 8 limbs to create and capture prey. Instead, it derives from the fact that it is the lone surviving member of the order Vampyromorphida. The squid is a dark crimson color, and its lights are bioluminescent, which makes it look scary. The vampire squid's defense mechanism consists of raising its arms in a protective coiled position and exposing little spiky projections when it feels threatened. It has the ability to spew bioluminescent fluids, which will adhere to its enemy. This not only distracts the predator, which lets the squid get away, but also makes the squid easier to spot and possibly more aggressive. Number 9. Mariana Snailfish. This fish lives so far down in the ocean that it would explode if it ever came up to the water's surface. The Mariana snailfish is the deepest diving fish ever caught. It is speculated that this particular fish lives between the depths of 6,198 meters and 8,076 meters in the Mariana Trench. The snailfish, which lacks scales but has loose skin instead, resembles a tadpole in appearance. Tiny crustaceans that it finds on the floor are the perfect size for its tiny teeth. When fully mature, this fish can measure up to 28 centimeters in length. Snailfish appear to be abundant in the trench, and they are not known to have many natural predators. The snailfish, like many other animals that live at great depths, is thought to be completely blind and to use its other senses to find food and get around. Number 8. Benzocodon jellyfish. The benzocodon is a species of jellyfish that lives in very deep water and has a distinctive alien-like appearance. In contrast to the majority of jellyfish, which are transparent, these ones have a vivid red hue and are quite small in size. These jellyfish spend their entire lives adrift in the depths of the ocean, propelled through the water by their thousands upon thousands of little tentacles. It is believed that the red bell on their bodies conceals the light given off by the critters that the creature has consumed. Because of this, it can keep its camouflage in the dark and stay hidden from both its prey and the animals that might try to eat it. Number 7. Barrel eye fish. Another fascinating marine mammal found in the ocean is the barrel eye fish. Spookfish is another name for them. The fish gets its name from the tube or barrel-like appearance of their eyes. They are oriented in an upward direction in order to allow the fish to detect prey more easily. The translucent dome on top of its head conceals huge nostrils that are frequently misunderstood as eyes. When the fish eats jellyfish, the dome shields it from stings and gives it a futuristic look. Barrel eyes are known to float around in the water, waiting for prey to swim by. They have big fins that help them stay in place and let them strike right away when the chance comes up. Number 6. Ping pong tree sponge. This tree covered in ping pong balls is actually a fish eating sponge. When you're deep underwater, it seems like just about any form of insanity is acceptable. The ping pong tree sponge grows up to 20 inches tall, with the majority of that height coming from a single stalk. A strange collection of globules made of airy substance rests at the tips of stalks that branch out from its main body. They may look harmless and ethereal, but these blobs aren't what they appear. This is where the flesh eating begins. The spicules, the microscopic components that make up a sponge's skeleton, cover the bumps. The shape of the hook fits this instance perfectly. Small crustaceans that come into contact with them become entangled because their bristly hairs stick to the hooks like Velcro. The ping pong tree sponge's cells creep gently toward the flailing prey to begin digestion. Number 5. Pink see-through fantasia. The pink see-through fantasia is a species of sea cucumber that was only found for the first time in 2007. It is an amazing creature that was first found in 2007. It is a species of free-swimming sea cucumber that has not been discovered before. It is possible to see the animal's mouth, anus, and intestines from the outside. This species is capable of emitting light, just like other types of bioluminescent organisms. When it senses that it is in danger, it flashes its light to scare away any prospective enemies. They propel themselves through the water using the finger-like webbing that runs under their bodies. The cucumber has the ability to feed on the silt that is found on the ocean floor while swimming in the water above the ocean floor. The pink see-through fantasia is an odd species that protects itself from predators by using bioluminescence on its skin. Number 4. Hermit crabs. If you look closely, you can see that it is clutching a sea anemone between two of its legs, even though it doesn't look all that different from its kin that live closer to the surface of the water. In their natural state, hermit crabs live inside empty shells. Nevertheless, the protective shell of this anemone acts as the crab's home. This hermit crab, most likely of the genus Peripagurus, has substituted an anemone for its shell. Although it would appear that the crab is lacking a pair of legs, the legs are actually modified in such a way that they serve to secure the anemone. The deep water exploration of the Marianas in 2016 mission was led by NOAA, in which they were discovered for the first time in the Mariana Trench. Number 3. Predatory tunicate. This creature of the deep is not as innocuous as it initially appears. While other members of its species are filter feeders, the tunicate's huge mouth is used to capture unwary crustaceans. Along the canyon walls and bottom of the deep ocean, predatory tunicates wait for small animals to drift or swim into their cavernous hoods. If you have ever witnessed a Venus flytrap capturing an insect, you have an idea of how the predatory tunicate consumes its prey. Its mouth-like hood quickly closes when a little animal enters. After capturing a meal, the tunicate seals its trap until it is ready to eat again. Each predatory tunicate is a simultaneous hermaphrodite, producing both sperm and eggs. Each tunicate can reproduce on its own if the environment is not good, or if there are no other tunicates nearby. Number 2. Acorn worms. These creatures, which were first discovered in 2012, are only found in extremely deep water and can grow to be over 2 meters in length. Also, the vivid hues of these items are eye-catching. For long lengths, they can glide through the water on their wing-like appendages. There are acorn worms in the sand, and even deeper in the ocean at depths of over 3,200 meters along the coast. Some deep-sea organisms reside on the bottom, while others live in U-shaped burrows. Some species consume sediment, like earthworms, while others filter seawater for food through gill silts in the throat. They also produce a slime that is carried into the mouth on the tips of their tiny hairs. Number 1. Giant grenadier fish. This bug-eyed fish, which can grow to reach a meter in length, cruises just above the bottom of the Mariana Trench in search of living prey. It defends itself by using a specific chemical molecule that emits a foul odor. Researchers have found that this kind of fish contains abnormally high concentrations of a compound known as TMAO. This substance is present in the bodies of all marine organisms. In a salty environment, its presence aids in keeping bodily tissues adequately hydrated. Fish would quickly die from dehydration if this chemical wasn't present in the water. They leisurely glide over the ocean floor in pursuit of both living and dead prey. As a result of its extremely high concentration of the foul-smelling chemical molecule TMAO, The rat tail is probably not only repulsive in appearance, but also offensive in odor. When Bob Ballard's expedition used ROV equipment to record the Titanic's wreckage, these fish were a typical sight among the debris. Well guys, that's all for today's video. What creature do you find most terrifying? Tell us your views in the comment section. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video. See you in the next video. Until then, take care.